Soma, what's it like down there? Is it still the same?
Same as when you were down there, you mean?
Yeah. I mean, everything was all blown up and really dirty.
Oh.
There were lots of sick people everywhere, too. And lots of people crying.
That about sums it all up. The world is still a huge mess.
Onushi wa nani mono? Koko wa doko da? Seisha no ken? Seisha no ken wa doko da? Sappari wakaran. Koko ga doko nano ka mouse? Seisha no ken wa dou shita? Nani wo itte oru no da? Sappari wakaran. Nantoka shite kure.
Where are they? Where are the little buggers? Aliens? That what you call them? So you woke me, huh? Who the hell are you? Do I really look that stupid, kid? This ain't a ship. I don't hear water, and I sure as hell don't feel us rocking. So tell me another one. Besides, you don't look trapped to me. How do I know you ain't working with those little green bastards? You got a point there, kid. Let me out of that thing does count for something. Tell you what. I usually ride solo, but I'll stick with you for now. You try and pull anything stupid, and I'll bury you.
There isn't anyone left to fix anything.
What's going on? Who are all these people? My what? Who the hell are you? Oh my god. Wait a minute. Aliens! I was taken by aliens! You! You must be the aliens trying to get into my mind. Well, that's not gonna work! Private Elliot Tekorian, U.S. Army medic, serial number 3477809. That's all I'm telling you. I don't know. Maybe you assumed human form. I heard they can do that. Or you are human, but they took over your mind. We have no idea how limitless their powers are. You do? Then you're telling me the truth. Those aliens took you too. Look, I just want to get out of here and get back to things the way they were. Back with my guys. Wait a minute. My men, my unit. Have you seen them? Oh my god. I'm responsible for them. And now they're lost. Or dead. Please, if you mean what you say, that we're all in this together, then you've got to help me find out what happened to them. Thank you. Thanks so much. Sorry about all this. I just can't believe this is happening. I'd really like to, but when I woke up on this ship for the first time, all of my medical gear was gone. I saw that the aliens on this ship have some sort of viscous stuff they slather onto wounds. Some kind of biological gel. Get me some of that, and I might be able to mess around with it, make some sort of adapted biogel we can use on ourselves. I'm still gonna need more alien biogel before I can make any more of the healing gel. Well, it was getting dark. We'd spent the day out in the trenches, keeping as many of the guys alive as we could. Chinese had been pounding on us all day with artillery from these huge guns they had up on the mountains. It was really a mess. Anyway, we pitched our tents and stowed our gear to try and catch some shut-eye. I woke up suddenly, Private Dawkins screaming. He was bathed in some kind of blue light coming from the sky. All of us just froze as he just, well, vanished. We didn't know what happened. Did the Chinese come up with some new weapon? Moments later, All of us were in the blue light too. The rest, you know. Or maybe, just maybe, they're responsible for life on Earth. Like, they seeded the planet a really long time ago. And they've been coming back every once in a while to check on the progress. And now they've decided they don't like how it turned out. Can you imagine? They made us, and now they're pissed at us! Maybe they're gonna take over the whole planet. Like, maybe they've been coming here for hundreds, no, thousands of years, waiting to hit us when we're not expecting it. And then they wipe us out and strip the planet of all its resources. I bet that's it. Isn't it obvious? They're probably using us as guinea pigs, examining our anatomy. Once they've figured out how to make exact copies of us, they'll send those copies back down to Earth to take our places. When they've copied enough of us, they'll turn on us and take over the world. Come on! How can you not see that coming? Me? Well, I was a medic with the 108th Infantry Battalion stationed at Anchorage, Alaska. I was with a squad of five other medics. Our job was to patch everyone up after the commies gunned them down. It was pretty bloody. Nothing at all like I expected when I gave up my hospital job to enlist in the Army. He looks like a Japanese samurai. Guess the aliens must have plucked him from Earth a long time ago. I can't understand a word he's saying. Sure, just watch my back and I'll watch yours.
Maybe we should just stay up here then. I hated when it was like that.
Hey, at least down there we're free. Well, most of us anyway. So let's just get the hell out of here.
Hey there, little one. So, are your parents anywhere aboard this ship?
Nah, just me and my sister.
妖怪から身を守るには剣がいる!
Hiya, mister.
I hope that little girl...
Yeah? What is it? Doesn't matter now. Only important thing is... Well, I guess it's revenge. Doesn't matter. They're not getting it, whatever it is. Can't say as it matters, or that I'd feel like telling you anyway. Okay, let me ask you something. You ever listen to the two people you care most about in this world screaming in pain? Huh? You ever watch them screaming, looking to you to save them, only you can't do anything about it? If you had any idea what that feels like, you'd know damn well it's not okay. I lost my wife and my boy to these monsters, and they are gonna suffer for it. No sense in dwelling on it now. Let's just get out of here. Some sort of foreigner, obviously. Can't make out a word he's saying. Suit yourself.
Knows what she's talking about, or we're in for some serious trouble. Hope this is important. Actually, I do. I used to tinker with all sorts of junk back home. I'd be glad to take a look at what you need fixed, but it's gonna cost you some caps. Maybe to you, it does. But hey, I gotta think about the future. If we get back down there and I'm broke, how am I going to survive? You know as well as I do that there are no handouts in the wasteland. Good. I'm glad we see eye to eye. Now, let me see what you need fixed. Hope this is important. Go on, don't let me stop you. If you got something you want to say, spit it out. Not much to tell. I heard that radio signal, thought I'd check it out. Thought maybe I could pull some scrap from whatever was sending the signal. Got a little more than I bargained for. Hell if I know. I don't plan on starting a conversation to ask, you know? Does it really matter? I mean, we're fighting to stay alive here. Whatever I did before we got to this point doesn't mean a whole lot right now. No idea what his deal is. Sounds like that gibberish you can pick up on the radio in some parts of the wasteland. Yeah. Just don't think about ditching me. We're in this together.
Oh no! That poor astronaut. Those freezers are so dangerous. Sometimes people don't wake up. I guess you better take his suit. You're going to have to go if he can't. But first, you have to get to the door to the outside. They'll be waiting for you. But you can suck out all the air in part of the ship, so they won't get in your way. They have these generator things that power parts of the ship and make sure it has air. You'll have to turn some of them off. There's one in the cryo lab, one in the hangar bay, and one where they make the robots, the robot assembly area. Once they're all broken, you can get through that door to the outside. And then, once you get to the top of the ship, you can turn the teleporter thing back on, and I can catch up to you. I guess it's time for me to get those doors unlocked for you now. This is fun! Oh, you'll know them when you see them. You push this button, and then this big thing is like, whoosh, and it comes out of the floor. And then, there are these things you press down, and it goes, and then you better get out of the way. You'll see. I think he's from the Earth's past. There are people frozen all over the ship that the aliens grabbed, wearing funny old-time clothes and stuff. Don't go alone. Those generators are in scary places. Take one of the grown-ups with you.
What's on your mind?
It's a pretty big place, and I've only seen some of it. They always catch me before I see the whole thing. I've seen the cryo lab. That's where they freeze people and cut them up and stuff. And the hangar. That has the aliens' flying ships and all the stuff they need to fly them. And the robot assembly is where they build the big metal robots they use. But the real important stuff is on the top of the ship. I've never been there. Be careful, mister.
Thank you.
Whoa, hang on a tick. I don't know anything about anything in this section, so I'm heading back to the engine core.
A few seconds, and I just knew you took out one of those generators. All you have to do is two more, and we can leave. Don't worry, I'll be safe with these guys. They seem pretty neat.
He's not going anywhere. Why don't we just hold on to him and try to negotiate?
Got one, eh? Well, this is fun.
is all you need to take care of. And we can get to the bridge and kick some alien butt! Be careful, mister.
Thank you. Thank you.